Some people say we're all connected. All part of some bigger picture. Some harmonious flow, endless and meaningful. Maybe that's how it looks from a distance. But up close, with eyes open, I see no evidence of any spiritual choreographer at work. No, I see nothing but the random fractals of a selfish, queenless hive. Never looking, never stopping, never meeting. Don't get me wrong, yeah? I'm not judging anyone. I mean, I want to get home as fast as the next person. But is it my unwavering selflessness that allows others to go before me? Or the selfish knowledge that the last one will be the first off? I mean, someone is always going to end up standing right by the door. I'm just good at making sure it's me. Like it or not, life's a sinister competition, an endless series of choices, large or small, each with its own set of probabilities. Or wind. Now that is an 80% chance this is my train. It's worth a dash.
Excuse me, this train...
Random variables. Never underestimate the human factor.
Bond Street?
I'm sorry, mate, that's my train.
Bond Street, here.
Look, it's on the other platform, mate.
Which platform, please?
Just through there.
Thank you. Two cars out, the rest are logged. Should be a nice, quiet night. See you tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do.
And here they are. The most meaningful relationship I've ever had in my life. With a bunch of metal bimbos. Look at you, my beauty. You could keep me in college for over a decade.
Careful the way he saturates it with his ego. Ah, here he is. Did you put all wrongdoers to flight?
You can leave the keys to me, sir. I'll park the car for you.
I'm not the driver, son.
I do beg your pardon, madam.
No problem.
No tip.
Him or her, fuck.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes choices are so small you don't even see them. You are your decisions, that's what shapes you. And that last one shaped me into a little bit of a chauvinist, just like that pig in a suit.
Get something?
Not exactly.
I'm sorry about before, you know, just assuming like that.
Oh, ignore him. He was being an arsehole.
I think your boyfriend's an arsehole.
Don't you? But, he does have a nice car. What are you reading?
Just a little bit of light study.
Looks pretty heavy to me.
Can I help you with something?
I need a favor. I need the keys to the Maserati.
Does Dr. Brent know?
Of course he does.
Okay. Okay, then you won't mind signing for it then.
Okay, he doesn't know. It's a secret, but I really need those keys. It's just for tonight. I'll be back before two.
Okay.
Good boy.
What's in it for me?
I'll owe you one.
One what?
One favour.
How do I know you're good for your favours?
You can bank my favours.
Fuck.
What?
It's nothing. Not a scratch, not a stain, nothing. All right? You fiddle with your lipstick outside of the car, and you wipe your shoes before you get in.
Anything else?
Yeah. You're back here by one. Not a minute later.
Yes, sir.
What do you want from me?
I want you to tie her up.
No, I'm not tying anyone up.
You're gonna tie her up right now.
But this is insane.
Please!
You heard the lady.
Get her off!
Sorry.
You open it up. She goes inside.
You're out of your fucking mind!
Fuck's sake!
Right. Now you get in the car. Oi, dickhead! Does it look like I can drive? You get behind the wheel.
You want me to drive you out of here?
That's exactly what you're gonna do.
Get back here. Fuck!
Hey, aren't you the guy from the car park?
Listen, let me give you a ride.
There's no more trains going from there anymore.
No, I'm all right, mate.
That's
my train.
Not anymore.
Oh, shit.
Get in the car, Sunshine. Get in the fucking car.
Student, okay? I've got no money. My family's got no money. What am I to you?
A problem, that's what.
You know the guy broke into the garage, don't you?
Maybe.
I didn't see his face, okay? I can't identify anyone.
But you can identify me. Just relax.
Who's the baggage?
His fucking mistake. What the hell happened in that garage?
The carabiner failed.
What happened to your arm?
He fell 15 feet onto a concrete floor.
This is your idea of a slick operation. Dripping DNA all over the place. Letting an eyewitness get away.
I got the card, didn't I? It's outside.
Jesus Christ!
And who the hell's gonna drive? Because you're clearly not. I'll be all right.
Fucking idiot. It has to be four people. There is no way you can manage the auction assistant and everyone downstairs on your own.
I'm well aware of how many people it has to be.
You have to call it off.
Do you want to tell Mr. Wu that we missed the one chance to get our hands on his fucking rice bowl? Because I don't. We have one window of opportunity and we're going to use it.
Fine. How?
Leave him to bleed. Need to make some calls and try and find a replacement in the next... Shit, in the next 30 minutes. Call Danny if he doesn't pick up. Try and get hold of that, you know, Irish Pete.
What about him?
Let's put a bullet in him. I don't care.
Look, I don't know who you guys are or what you're up to, okay? I'm not gonna say anything to anyone.
Well, it's not gonna take you long to figure it out, is it?
Well, no, not if you keep talking in front of me, it won't.
It'll be on the news, smartass.
I'm not a murderer, I don't intend to start now. Pass me diphenoxine and a couple of cable ties. You stay where you are.
Look, you said you wouldn't hurt me.
No, I said I wouldn't kill you. That still leaves lots of painful options. Not good at maths, are you, mate?
What's that supposed to mean?
Minus one, plus one.
I mean zero.
Yeah, zero problems. Look, you need someone to help you out. And I need someone not to stick a fucking syringe in me.
Why on earth would I trust you?
Because you don't have a choice. Just like I don't.
See your point.
Are you serious?
Are you going to go to the basement?
We've got no idea who he is.
After tonight, we're not going to see him again. What difference does it make?
The difference is this guy looks like trouble.
Well, Mr. Wu is trouble, and we've made a deal with him we can't go back on.
What do you say?
I don't care who does what, as long as I get my cut.
You better not fuck this up.
What about the money? Don't push your luck. I'm taking his risk, so I want his share.
Fuck off!
Shut up, idiot.
I'll be worth the money.
Okay, I'll tell you what, you two split 50-50, that's the deal.
Done.
You can't do this!
It's done. Listen.
You're joking.
We'll find you something.
What do I do next? Do I go along with this and then try and turn him in? Or do I keep my mouth shut and take the money? Mystery ladies and difficult choices. So much for the quiet night.
I think you need to tell me what we're doing here.
Nerve going already?
Just like to be prepared, that's all.
A very powerful Chinese clan called the Choys are here tonight to reacquire a porcelain ball that has been in the possession of their family for over 1,000 years.
Reacquire? What went wrong?
A careless business transaction?
So we're here to help them get it back?
We're here to stop them getting it back.
I presume we're not buying it.
What do you think?
Great. You know, I gave up stealing a long time ago.
To do what?
To study.
Then tonight's your lucky night.
How do you work that out?
Because the only thing studying will get you is unemployment.
Failed education is still no excuse for stealing, you know.
We're stealing from people who are prepared to spend millions on a piece of pottery when there are far more worthy causes in the world.
What on your worthy cause are you?
Tonight I am.
Who's fooling themselves now? A crime's still a crime.
Welcome to Hainsworth's. The second part of the auction has just begun.
Thank you.
$9.10 to my left. Thank you, sir. $9.10. $9.20. $9.20. Thank you.
I see you.
$9.30. Again to my left. $9.40. Do I hear $9.40? $9.40. Thank you, sir. Looking for $9.50. $9.50 to my left. Do I hear $9.60? Fair warning. I'm selling. $9.50 once. $9.50 twice. Sold for £950,000. This marvellous 12th century cabinet with its hidden compartment, which is...
£950,000
for its time.
Just try to keep it purgatory.
I'm sorry. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't spend it on a fucking sideboard. Sorry.
Why don't you try not talking at all?
So we come to what I feel must be the highlight of our sale this evening, lot 247. And to introduce it, first I'd like to pass you over to our expert, Miss Katie Tran. Katie.
What we have here is an absolutely exquisite example of late Ming Dynasty porcelain.
Go upstairs now, mate. Is the ball there?
One of only three remaining examples of the red phoenix pattern known to be in existence. Sebastian, if you would, please.
Thank you very much indeed, Katie. It is a truly exceptional piece, the sale of which cannot be passed without remarking that its owner, Mr. Samuel Parr, who is far too modest to mention it himself, has agreed to donate 50% of the sale proceeds to the Chinese Art Restoration Fund.
Yeah, he can't afford it.
What did we say about not talking?
And so, we shall begin the selling. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Sebastian. And I would like to start the bidding, please, at £2 million. £2 million. Thank you, madam. £2 million I have to my left. Three I'm looking for. Do I hear three? Three at the back. Thank you, sir. Do I hear four? Four. Four for the lady. Thank you, madam. Four I'm bidding.
What the fuck are you doing?
Do I hear five?
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing?
Five, you get 20% of the sale price, don't
you? On the phone. Five I have. Do I hear six? Six I'm looking for. Six to my right. Thank you, sir.
How powerful did you say these toys are?
Do I now hear seven? Seven I have to the lady.
Mate,
thank you,
stop
madam.
Bidding.
Seven. Do I hear eight? Eight I'm looking for. Eight with you, sir, to your bid. Looking for nine.
Matt, stop her.
Do I hear nine? Nine in the room? Nine I'm looking for. Nine to the lady. Thank you, madam.
Christ
I'm looking for 9-5, ladies and gentlemen. 9-5. 9-5. 9-5 to my right. So do I hear 10?
Matt, stop this.
Don't talk to him, talk to me.
We're looking to break 10. Thank you, madam.
Are you out of your
fucking 10 we have. We are at 8 figures in the room, ladies and gentlemen. 10 is your bid, madam. It's against you now, sir. So do I hear 10-5?
You are so getting lumbered with this.
10-5. 10-5 I have. Thank you. Now do I hear 11? 11 I have with the lady.
I'm going to have a heart attack.
Thank you, madam. 11, it's your bid, madam.
Yeah, gut feeling.
11,
okay,
so...
because, you know, price
we have
11, 5. Logarithmic curve, derivative
11,
approaching 5. Zero. So the chances of getting away with another bid...
little bit. At 11, madam.
What, 11.5. 18.5%.
Trust me.
11.5. 11.5 I have. Thank you very much, sir. 11.5. It's your bid. It's against you now, madam. It's against you, sir. 11.5. 11.5 with you, sir. Fair warning. I'm selling. 11.5 once. 11.5 twice. 12 million I have. Thank you, madam. 12 it is. So do I hear 12.5? 12.5 I'm looking for. 12.5. It's your bid at 12, madam. Looking for 12.5. 12.5. 12.5 I have to my right. Thank you, sir. 12.5. So do I hear 13? It's against you now, madam. 12.5. Are we all out? At 12.5, fair warning, I'm selling. 12.5 once. 12.5 twice. So, to the gentleman on my right, for £12.5 million. Thank you very much.
Let's get the hell out of here. You see, the wall doesn't turn on mathematics, you know.
Yeah, but mine does.
Well, maybe that's your problem.
Right now, you're my bloody problem.
A problem that just increased your cut by about 25%? Now that's mathematics.
All right, where to?
The basement. Jeffrey's going to call the lift from downstairs.
Okay, and then?
Then you're going to take out the security guard.
I'm sorry, I'm going to do what?
Just follow Jeffrey's instructions, darling. We're a couple, remember?
So what do I do? Do I play along and try and get out of this later? Or do I try and stop this little crime wave dead in its tracks? Okay, what are my options? I can warn the security guard instead of attacking him. Or I can take this lift up to a higher floor and maybe warn one of the employees. Or go up to the roof and maybe try and escape from there.
Doing in here?
Yeah, what the fuck am I doing here? What's my story?
Okay, look, I know this sounds crazy, but someone is about to rob this place. Look, listen to me. Right now, they've got into your security system. They're already in the basement.
Is this some sort of joke? Security?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Things are complicated.
Oh shit.
Are video feeds cut?
Oh, I fucking hope so.
Fuck!
What the fuck did you do?
Upstairs, let's go bring him. Hey, Link, we need to come out the front room. We crashed the front of the building. Okay, everyone! Open the fucking door! Come on!
Open the door.
It's open! You, come with me! Come on!
Trust you. You're a dead man. You should know this. You're not your Santa.
You're not a murderer.
I haven't really had a problem with that. I mean, why the fuck did you agree to do this? I thought you wanted him.
I wanted to avoid a needle in the neck, man.
Big mistake. You're a fucking idiot.
Gentlemen, we are back in society.
Can you see it? I want to see the bomb.
Just wait. This thing stays in the bag until we get to Wu's place and turns it into money.
Too fucking right.
You gotta take a left. Some Shoreditch High Street. Hong Kong City restaurant.
Sounds classy.
What are we gonna do about this comedian?
Give him to me. I'll pop him.
Hey, that's not what we agreed.
Not here, just keep him quiet until we get rid of this ball. There should be some gaffer tape in the back somewhere.
Look out! Mei Ling, can you hear me? Open your eyes. Okay, there's petrol, look, we gotta get out. Right? Fuck! Take this ball to the police where it belongs.
What?
You heard me.
Are you out of your mind?
Oh, look, I'm not a criminal, all right?
You think the police will believe? You were seen in the auction house. You are a criminal.
No, I'm a security guard and I'm bringing the ball back.
You're an accessory, plain and simple.
Watch me. Under arrest.
Not yet. You allege someone forced you to steal this?
Yeah. They threatened to drug me.
Threatened to drug you? Convenient.
I'm telling you the truth.
Will you be the judge of that, sir?
Like you said. This robbery occurred over 2 hours ago. Took you a while to locate your conscience, didn't it?
Yeah, well, they had guns. Getting away hasn't exactly been easy.
So it seems. Exploding vans, mysterious Chinamen. You know what I think? I think you're up to your balls in this, but you got scared, and now you're trying to lie your way out.
I'm telling you the truth.
Anyone to back you up?
There was a girl.
You do surprise me. Where's she at?
She wouldn't come with me.
Sounds like the brains of the operation.
I'm trying to do the right thing here. Yeah, why don't you investigate this Mr. Wu? He's the guy that they stole the bowl for. He runs a restaurant in Shoreditch, that's all I know.
Tony Wu is sitting in the room right next to us, and he's very convincingly denied any involvement in your little enterprise. In fact, when we told him what you stole, he nearly stopped breathing.
Any thoughts? Do you know who the Choi family are? Because Tony Wu does. And he knows fine well not to fuck with them. I think you didn't realize that until after you stole the bowl. And now you're sitting here, shitting yourself, looking for a way out. I want you to talk to somebody. Do you recognize this woman?
What the fuck is this?
What do I have here?
Answer her.
It's the Chinese bowl we stole from the auction house tonight.
No, it's not. Even though it fools the eye, I must admit. Which is why we rely on an effect called thermoluminescence. It's used to determine when the porcelain was fired. The bowl was created during the late Ming Dynasty, somewhere between 1368 and 1644. So it should be
between 647 and 371 years old.
I guess that's about right. But unlike the bowl I examined this evening, this thing here is less than 5 years old.
So where is the original?
Hey, where is it?
Fuck.
Yes, I dare say. Start talking.
To a solicitor, no one else.
Appreciate you coming down, Miss Tran. We'll keep you informed. Matthew Thompson, I am arresting you on suspicion of armed robbery.
What the fuck?
You do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defense if you do not mention when questioned something you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Look, I really don't know where it is.
Tell it to your solicitor.
Vehicle 721 in position on City Road. Copy that, 721. Please hold until further notice.
Where are you taking me?
CID at Knightsbridge. They want you to talk them through the robbery. If you want my advice, I'd help them do it. Start getting a few plus points on your record. Get a year or two off your sentence.
Can't believe it's come to this. Where did I go wrong? Where did I make the wrong choice?
Clive, you see this?
Where is it? I don't know. I don't know where it is.
We've all had a very long night. If you don't come to your senses, I can assure you that yours will become even longer. Where's the ball?
I haven't got it.
Lies. The police informed us, the rightful owners, about what we've done. Where are you hiding it?
Oh, look, I haven't got your fucking rice bowl, or...
Disrespect will be punished. Now for the final time, where is the bowl you took from the auction? Not the copy you brought to the police. The original. The original bowl that you stole, where?
You've got the wrong guy. What the fuck is that?
You know where the bowl is. You and your lady friend. Next door. Both of you know. One of you will tell.
What have you done to her?
So you admit to your partnership with her?
I never met her before tonight. Okay, I was part of the robbery, but it wasn't my choice. I don't know anything about fakes or forgeries or anything else for that matter, okay? As far as I'm concerned, the bowl in my pocket was the real bowl.
He got me.
Go on, what is he?
Go to the one I've been. Name who's more Gong? I've been
I don't understand what the fuck you're saying to me.
Bowl equals pain. The longer you have bowl, the longer you have pain. Very simple mathematics.
Fuck! Fucking hell. Look, I haven't got your fucking rice bowl, okay? Fuck!
I don't care if you have it or your girl. The bowl is ours. First to tell truth is free. The other is punished.
The classic prisoner's dilemma. Game theory first term. Whatever I tell them lives or dies on what Mei Ling tells them, and vice versa. If our answers are inconsistent, one of us dies.
Choose.
What?
Choose punishment. Know your fate.
The long one.
Good choice. Very honorable death. One turn and it twists your intestines like a key. Death comes slowly over a long, long time.
Great.
Where is the bull? The original bull.
Can I trust her to be reasonable? Or will she keep quiet? Because if she does that, she dies. Okay. Okay. I'll do it. I'll get you the bowl.
So your memory returns?
I wish.
Where is it?
I can't tell you. I have to go and get it for you.
Not good enough.
It's the only way you're going to get it.
I call the jade up there.
You bring us the bowl, and she'll be punished.
No, it should be her. She should get it. Keep me instead.
It's decided. You bring us the bowl. If you fail, she dies.
It's Pa. He's the one who fucked us. He fucked us all.
How do you know that?
Because I'm the one who forged the copy for him.
Oh, fuck me.
Enough. Time to go.
I didn't mean for any of this to happen. I'm sorry.
Where's the original?
I don't know.
For what he's done to us. What the hell is he playing at? Rich fucking bastard. What the fuck am I doing? Am I really doing this? All right. Just keep walking. Just keep moving. Fuck, I really have no time for this. On stage had it, right before we stole it. Right, how do I find him?
Claire?
really sorry to call this late, but it's Sebastian at home.
Who's speaking, please?
It's Dan from work. I heard he was in an accident. Is he all right? Is he at home?
No, he's not well. He's been taken to the hospital. He has a serious concussion. It's horrible.
I'm really sorry to hear that. Where did they take him?
They took him to St. Thomas's, but they won't let me visit until the morning.
St. Thomas's, thank you. I'm really sorry this happened.
Don't worry, it's not your fault.
I'm sorry though.
All right, let's pay this poor guy a visit.
Hi. You work here?
As you can see.
Weren't you supposed to be going out?
The night somehow started badly.
Oh, I'm sorry you got involved.
I'm sorry you did. What brings you here?
I'm here to see someone. Can you tell me what room Sebastian Leclerc's in, please? Is he here?
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Oh, come on. It's just a room number.
Look, I know you wanted to help me out tonight, but I can't give you any information about that patient.
So he's here.
I shouldn't have even told you that.
Just 5 minutes, please.
Shit. Seventh floor, room 703, and if you get caught, I've never seen or heard of you.
Thank you.
They won't let me use the internet.
Oh my God. That's how he got the ball at the auction house.
Because of the crimes committed at Hainsworth tonight.
You shouldn't be here, nurse. Nurse!
Now you listen to me, mate. I'm a peaceful man, okay? I do not want to hurt you. But if you try that shit again, I swear to God, the bits of you that hurt are gonna get a whole lot worse. Do you understand me? Do we have a deal?
Yes.
Good. Tell me about your deal with Samuel Parr. I know you replaced the porcelain rice bowl with a forgery.
That's a lie.
I know what you did, Sebastian. Parr's cabinet. The one he bought right before the bowl was auctioned. The one with the secret compartment. That's right. The forgery was hidden inside before the auction, wasn't it? And then afterwards, you replaced it with the original. You're the only one who could have done it, Sebastian. The only one.
Dad, what do you want? What do you want from me?
Where's the original? Does Paul have it?
If I tell you, you have to promise to tell no one about me.
You're kidding, right?
If you don't promise, I tell you nothing.
I don't have time for this, mate.
with me now? Now, where's the fucking rice bowl? It's the last time I'm gonna ask you nicely.
Okay. Okay. I swapped it. I swapped it in the elevator. The original with the forgery, and I hid it.
The cabinet. Pa's cabinet I bought an auction. There was a secret compartment in it, right?
Yes.
Is that where it is? Is the bowl still inside?
I don't know. This is the truth. The security took everything to the safe storage after the robbery, and they brought me here to the hospital.
Safe storage? So it's still inside Hainsworth?
Yes.
Oh, painkillers, thank Christ. Will this get me into the vault?
Yes, if you can get to it, yes.
I was never here, right?
Yes. And you never heard about a hidden compartment.
Get well soon.
Yeah. Come on.
I'll be with you in a moment.
No rush. Long flight.
How can I help you?
I'm here to pick up an item.
What lot was it?
It was an item bought last night by Mr. Samuel Parr.
No, it's not on my list. Do you have your documentation?
I was told my copy will be waiting at this desk.
I can't do anything without the lot numbers. Would you like to speak to someone upstairs?
Yeah, I think that would be best.
Okay, if you take the elevator to the second floor, Mr. Quinn is in room 13. I'm sure he'll be able to sort this out for you.
Great, thanks a lot.
You're welcome, sir.
Cancel this card.
Doors closing.
Going up?
Yeah.
Your colleague let me in.
Who?
Mr. Quinn.
Mr. Quinn?
Mr. Quinn, yeah.
Wait here.
Oh, yes. Okay. Doable.
You going down?
Yeah, thank you.
Ground floor?
Car park.
You don't work here?
Picking up. Mr. Quinn sent me down. Oh shit, do I look shifty?
The car park's just through those rooms.
Thank you. Kill you.
I can't just do that anyway. We need to prove to them that this was part of the plan right from the start.
Any suggestions?
We need to get part of the mid.
Solsina.
Please don't go wrong.
Mei Ling. Fuck. What do I do? Do I risk going to Pa's house to get us both out of this? Or do I take it to the choice? Now's my chance. How could I live with that? I just need some kind of plan. Yeah, I got it.
Bring it to us.
No, not you, mate. I want to speak to the chief psycho. Samuel Parr?
Oh, Mr. Parr does not receive guests before 10 o'clock.
Oh, he'll want to see me. And he'll want to see me right now.
Wait here. Wait, you can't? Mr. Parr?
Thank you, Willa. I'll deal with this.
Who are you?
I'm here to tell you, that unfortunately Mr. Leclerc failed to carry out his task.
What the hell are you talking about?
The boy that was taken from Hainsworth tonight was a real one. Forgery never left that compartment.
Where is it? Where is it?
Catch. Don't worry. Just a copy. You don't think it'd be so stupid to come in here with the real one, do you?
Where's the original?
Mailing has it.
What does she want?
I don't know. Ask her.
Clever little girl, aren't you? Not just a pretty face.
We need to adjust our little deal.
How much?
Half the selling price.
6.25 million? I'd consider keeping the copy for that.
Then I might consider telling the choice.
You fucking little bitch!
Don't get on your high horse, Samuel. You tried to kill us all in that car crash.
And what about your bimbo?
Bimbo?
He's going to watch you transfer the money into my bank account. Then he's going to walk out of there and bring you the original. It's done?
It's done.
Now get me my original.
Okay. My friend is going to fetch it for you right now.
What the hell?
Mate, he knows.
Are you outside the house?
Mate, get out of there now. This is the bowl that Pa tried to steal from you. This is yours. It's got nothing more to do with this, all right?
Just wait! Mailing! Help me! Please!
What are you going to do with it?
Discuss the nature of Chinese heritage.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.